It's one of the biggest games of Tottenham Hotspur's season, one that fans have had their eye on for a while. Ange Postecoglou isn't speaking in terms of Champions League qualification, but these two teams are more than in the mix. On by McGinn. I think you'd call this an encouraging start from Spurs. Johnson. Great feet. Saar. Just to steer a pass into the path of Pedro Porro. Again, relatively direct to Watkins in this game. Villa in it. Might work for them again. Holds off Romero. Cash. Bailey. Cutback options there. Maddison does enough to put off Manny Cash. And he got the final touch. Score from a couple of set pieces first half against Luton, including a fine Ollie Watkins header. You're short with it this time to work a better angle from again. And Digne just wide. The match winner against Luton last week comes close. You'd imagine he would have been in Ronald Koeman's next Netherlands squad for the upcoming internationals. Radu Dragosin will come on for his most meaningful contribution as a Spurs player yet. The January signing is into the team here. Three brief cameos so far, his fourth appearance. He'll get nearly a full half. Porro. Lovely exchange of Kulusevski. Nearly gets that right to Saar, but he'll keep going here. Saar, early. What a ball! And James Maddison is there to meet it at Villa Park. Spurs strike first in this massive game in the Premier League. And James Maddison gets his first goal since coming back from injury. One gap, one glimmer of light. Spurs win for it. Well, it was Kulusevski and Saar who worked this. Pedro Porro involved too. Saar looks on there. And he kept going. But how about the quality of ball here? He went so early with the cross, he had to. But Spurs were clinical. Unai Emery's side for the first time looked defensively disjointed. Kulusevski given away. Three on one here. Son with Johnson. And it's the second goal. Brennan Johnson off the bench to have the impact last week. Starting and scoring this week. Strike twice in quick succession, and Emery cannot believe it. Had to be ruthless, and they were. Son to Johnson, 2-0 Spurs. Villa have been a bit careless since coming out for the second half. These lapses have been rare from them all season. But Konsa to Tielemans, picked off by Kulusevski. Does Johnson stay on? It looks like it. And the finish is superb. Brennan Johnson was relentless in the first half and gets his reward in the second. Clips it over Martinez. Udogi trying to settle things here around Diaby easily. And again, that's a yellow card surely. Just took a swing. A Destiny Udogi, and it's wild, the Spurs players. Son trying to get in the middle of it. Will VAR save him? Oh, it was wild. It was wild. No stud showing especially, but enough for the intent. It's a fury surprise to that wilder few. Red card, John McGinn. I must say, for all the frustration and anger from the Spurs players. I did not see that coming. Watkins, Basuma does well. Udogie, Son, oh brilliant. The way Spurs have played out here is extraordinary, and it's a three-on-three situation as Bentancur moves it to Kulusevski. Still Kulusevski. Shoots. Son furious, far side. Konsa looking to meet it. Zaniolo. Top save from Vicario, who's caught. He comes off now for Højbjerg. Timo Werner, fresh from his first goal, is on along with the Dane. Højbjerg. Dragosin. Pedro Porro. Kulusevski. He and Pedro Porro have worked it. Lots of options here for Kulusevski. Son! Absolutely brutal with the finish to finish off Aston Villa. A proper penalty box finisher. Three goals, 3 points going back to North London. The early unravelling in the second half has been Villa's undoing. And Son goes level with Cliff Jones as the club's fifth highest scorer ever. Well, Kulusevski and Pedro Porro were superb against this laboured-looking and defeated Aston Villa. And the finish is... Pedro Porro, Son again, and Martinez holds on this time. Bentancur trying to breeze away from Robinham. Son, oh great work. Werner! 2-2 for Timo! This has been some performance from Tottenham Hotspur. Timo Werner in added time, and after his goal last week against Palace, he's at it again. It's brilliant football, and Villa completely done. The exertions of the past few days, the red card, the two early goals in the second half, I've just seen them fall apart.